In this video, we're going to demonstrate how to create a flow for an API in App Connect to create a Salesforce contact. On the App Connect dashboard, click New, then Flows for an API. We need to name the flow, so we'll call it Customer API. We'll name the API Customer so that we can identify it. Click Create Model. Our API will create, update, and retrieve a customer. So in the Properties panel, we're going to use Customer ID, first name, last name, and email to identify our customer. By default, the first property that you add has the ID option selected. We want our flow to return a customer ID when we create the customer object, so we'll leave this default in place. Now we'll click Operations. We'll add the Create Customer operation to the customer model and click Implement Flow. So now we can see a basic flow in the flow editor with a request, a response, and a request body example. We'll click plus, then select Salesforce, contacts, and create contact. So now we're going to map the fields from the request into Salesforce create contact. Click within the field, click insert a reference, then select customer ID. Select last name, first name. Then type EM and select email from the list. Now we'll click the response in the flow to define the response that will be returned. For the response field, customer ID, we're going to map the Salesforce field, contact ID. We'll click done, and then click start API. That's great, our flow is now running. So now we'll test that our flow is working. On the Manage tab, scroll down to Sharing Outside of Cloud Foundry Organization. Click Create API Key. We'll name it Customer API Test. Then click Create. We'll click the API Portal link and the API opens up in an API Portal window. To invoke it, click Try It, then click Generate to populate the data field with sample customer data. We'll remove the customer ID information that's been generated because Salesforce will generate and return an ID for the customer that is created. Now click Call Operation, and we can see the success code 201 created and the response body with the customer ID value assigned by Salesforce. Now we'll open Salesforce, go to our contacts, and we can see that the new contact has been created. Thanks for watching.